Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Darkest Dungeon adventure here in week 85. So when we last left off, we got a couple of new recruits and they are currently going for some treatment inside of the sanitarium, meaning that we've got ourselves a little bit of a gap in between when we can take them out again versus what we can do right now. And right now it's looking like nothing but champion in the cove here. And again, the reason why we're worrying about the cove or the warrens, we could do a warrens run as well, is basically because we need to get our, we basically need to keep progressing up to the boss. The boss levels for the Cove and the Warren, so we can get, be done with everything and then start focusing on the final dungeon, which is going to be, of course, the Darkest Dungeon, as in the title of the game. So, basically what we're going to do today is it's going to be nothing fancy. We're just going to go straight for either a medium clear mission. We can go for cleanse. We can go for a map exploration as a long one, or we can just do another exploration of the... of the rooms. I think honestly the best thing, was the easiest and quickest thing we could do is going to be the exploration one, which is going to be a medium champion level mission. So who do we want to bring for a medium champion level mission of this caliber? Pretty much anybody. It doesn't really matter who we bring for this one. We just need a name. I mean, obviously money is going to be a factor. We're going to need a lot of money here. We should try to get somebody else other than Jesse leveled up, but honestly we can't afford the upgrades, so we just got to roll with what we've got right now as far as who is upgraded. We're not going for character progression right now. We are going for straight up progression through a dungeon. That is about it. So I'm gonna be bringing I'll be bringing Jesse here up front. I think we can I'll go ahead and roll with an occultist this time around. We could bring TB, or we could bring Maggie for the single target heals too. I'd like to actually bring a plague doctor. We could bring Cry or Crendoge for the bleeds and the blights and the blips and the zip zap zippity zips, which means that we're going to have to bring someone up close. And again, this is how we've lost our last two vessels, but you got to do what you got to do. This time around, we are going to have Kurt as well. So at least Kurt will be able to guard Maggie in case she does get in a little bit of trouble there this time around. I'm trying to think ahead here. I don't know how much ahead, but we're going to try anyway. So let's go ahead and put a tough ring on Kurt, and we'll also give him additional protection here with Barristan's head. For Maggie, obviously, we're just going to do exactly what we need to do again, which is first, of course, unequipping everything from our previous mission. Try this again. So for Maggie, we're going to go for the Sacred Scroll and Junia's head. Again, I like having the option of having that sort of damage back and forth like that. For Jesse, we're going to give him the tambourine, and we'll also give him a little bit. We could do... Actually, you know what? Let's try... Let's go for Ancestor's Pen. Let's just get crazy and have him do a little bit of extra damage here. And then for Cry, we're going to give him... We want to give him speed in the back position, so... Honestly, Fusion's Matchstick's not bad here because he also gets crit, but we also need the Blight skill chance. And we either go for the Poison Herb... We gotta go for the Poison Herb or Blasphemous Vial. I'm gonna go for the Blasphemous Vial. Only because it gives us a little bit of extra stun chance as well. It doesn't give us quite as much Blight skill as I'd like. You know what? Let's go ahead and go for Blight. Yeah. Let's stack the Blight. We really, really need to land those Blighting attacks. So, I don't think we're gonna be able to logically afford any upgrades here. Kurt's good. Jesse is good. We could give him the last rank of Harvest. Do we want to give him the last rank of Harvest? Nah, we'll keep a Slice off. I like having Slice off. Maggie is looking good. Might as well get those two out of the way. And then for... Who's the other one? Cry? Where's Cry at? There's Cry. Cry's good. Good. Alright, and we know exactly what armor upgrades we need. I know Kurt and Maggie both need one, I believe. Yeah, Maggie needs weapon, and Kurt also needs a weapon, so this is going to hurt a little bit. Alright, here we go. It's going to be a medium exploration mission. Again, we're going for progression here. We're not going for gold, but if we can get gold, that'd be great. I'd prefer to do a dark run if possible, but given the fact of how crazy we've been seeing things go for the past couple of runs now, who really the hell knows at this point? Bring two keys, and I'll bring a couple of torches. I don't want to bring a lot of torches here. We'll go for six torches. No anti, one anti-venom is fine. And yeah, let's do it. So basically what we need to do...
The smell of rotting fish is almost unbearable.
We need to just beat this dungeon. We're here for progression, not for gold, not for character XP, just progression. Traps
lie in wait.
I think that's, again, one of the... This is another run where it's the first step out of the gate and we get hit by a trap that lasts forever. And we got shuffled at 70% light as well. Good. And Cry had pretty much the worst shovel that we could have ever not hoped for. So already off to a really good start here in this run. Love everyone speed up just so we have actually have a chance to attack before the end of this first turn. Or we could just miss everything. That's good too. It's good to know. That did 26 stress damage? Does he have... Am I missing something here? Or does Kurt have... He doesn't have fear of humans. Why did that deal so much stress damage? That's insane. All right, well... Good, so we got ourselves quite the little job here. All right, we still need to move. We need to move Cry back so we can start hitting the back line. He's the only person who can, besides, I guess technically Jesse, you can hit the front line, the number three there. And Kurt got crit through. How much protection do we have stacked on him right now? He got crit for 28 through 23% protection. That's pretty good. Maggie getting the size of Filmbeck heals here at level 6 or whatever she is. All right, so after two rounds, we're able to get one attack so far. We're getting there, team. This is where we start to turn it around, I think. Let's go ahead. We need to move Jesse forward so we can actually start using Harvest. We're finally going to start dealing damage to the back line here. I think nerfing... okay, never mind. Not even going to say it. Cry gets pulled again to the only position that he really can't do anything. I mean, he can use Noxious Blast, but we really don't want him to. It's gonna keep bolstering and hoping that maybe we can get a kill. One of these rounds, it's gonna happen. When? I don't know. I have faith that we will be able to kill something one day in this run. All right. So I'm not even gonna bother moving Cry at this point. As he's just hit pulled off again. Double stress wave is good. Okay. And Kurt did hit. Hey, we landed a stun! Oh my goodness. I feel like it's a miracle that we're witnessing here. Alright, Maggie. All you have to do is heal. You don't even have to hit anything, just heal. Alright, good. You didn't miss a heal. Good. Very proud of you, Maggie. So we know that the witch will die this turn no matter what. We still can't do anything about the Tidemaster yet. Cry's gonna keep stacking the Blight on the Piranha. Maggie's going to miss predictably. And he's gonna be one off lethal. Nice indeed.
A terrible assault cannot be left unanswered.
The Piranha is going to die this turn.
This slow death.
Well, not this turn, but he'll unforeseen. Die this turn.
Unforgiving.
All right. I'm still not liking the fact that we got hit by that trap the first time right out the gate here. More stress spam. The one target that we needed to not leave alive, that we needed to kill first, is still alive. But again, I feel like there's not really much I could have done there with the misses and the shuffles and the zip zap zippy baps. I already made that joke. Alright, we got there. Cry, you did it. We did it, team. This is the first fight in the dungeon, by the way. I just want to make sure everyone's well aware of that. We've got a long way to go. This is how this run's going to be. I need to go get myself a little bit of stress relaxation. All right, we landed the stun, which is good. And we're going to blight him up again. He's going to die after this turn, so let's go ahead and make this... Hopefully Maggie will get to go first before he bleeds out. Probably not.
Yeah. Great is the weapon that cuts on its own.
All right, so that was about the worst possible thing that could have happened. Other than, of course, someone just keeling over and dying. With the fact that we couldn't get Cry in the position that we needed. And, yeah. So that was a good fight. Good first fight here, team. We're on our way. Use a shovel in the chest. Get the loot.
A fortune waiting to be spent.
What about a fortune, Uncle Wayne? So we do get a savage this time around. We did not get surprised. Thank you for that, game. I appreciate that. There's pretty much no way that our blight damage does not land at any point. Again, Cry got shuffled to where now Jesse can't attack, which again I'm not really too appreciative of, but hey, we'll take them as they come, I guess. As long as he doesn't get moved again, that's fine.
How quickly the tide turns.
Pretty much have to start healing because we can't stop getting crit on. And let's go for cover command. Command sounds great. We did land on Maggie through that. Nice hit by Jesse. I want to say that that was thanks to command. Probably going to land another round of blight, so that's going to be 12 damage. I think Maggie can heal through this. Could go for a bolster here with Kurt. One of the piranhas is down. He will die off in this next turn, which is good. I really wish Jesse with his 44 dodge would like dodge something. And he's gonna get moved. Did not get bled, I should say. We need to get Jesse back though, because we need to start taking care of the stress damage here. I'm going to actually move Maggie forward. As crazy as that sounds, and we're not going to be healing here. The reason why I did that is because we really need to start taking care of the stress. Kurt did not get bled. Alright. Now we're fighting the fight that we want to fight on turn 4. Cry throws down the dunk. Kurt going to continue to bolster our dodge. Maggie's gonna start trying to catch everyone up on heals. So we're able to stabilize here after a little bit of a wonky start in this fight. Nice resist on the debuff and the bleed. Again, the reason why you always want to, pretty much always want to bring a Plague Doctor into the cove is because all the blight damage goes right through the protection of said creature. And there's not a whole lot you really have to worry about. Plague Doctors can also take care of the bleeds, which is very important, as you see here from the arterial pinch of the Savage or the Crusher and the veteran level ones. They deal 10 damage every time they tick, so it's pretty bad. Go for another bolster here just to keep our dodge up. And we'll get some speed boost too. I'm going to try to top everyone off as far as Jesse is concerned, and then Cry can just continue to stack the blight over and over again on the Savage now. Let's tick it for 18. That's an impressive amount of damage over time that Cry is able to deal. So now they're going to go try to switch it up, go for Tidal Slam, which was easily dodged by Maggie. And with that, I think Cry... Yeah, he's going to die. He will die this turn, so... Well fought. This is how the fights are supposed to go. Everyone firing at all cylinder. We have the option to stress heal, or we have the option to to bleed with Jesse. It's a good time. Good time. Good fight. Obviously, I'm pretty happy about getting another secret door. It's going to help out our financials quite a bit.
Another mariner. Another misfortune.
And burn all the torches here. Need to be careful about our shovel consumption. We're down to one. And that is not what I wanted to see. We do not need deeds. So we can turn around now if we want to, but I'd rather get as many rooms as we can cross off as possible, given the fact that, I mean, and that's kind of directly tied to the amount of shovels that we have or don't have, because I want to have the option of turning around and skipping a room in case of, like, say, these two are blocked off by a shovel vent, we no longer have any shovels, we could simply just go up here and still be able to complete the dungeon without having to suffer that amount of backtracking stress damage. Alright, so we're going to have to take care of the front line first with the two stingers and the ghoul. Obviously the ghoul is terrible, but this reason why we have is Jester. Jester can outpace the stress damage of the ghoul, as long as we stay on top of it. And yeah, we're just going to get another disease. So there's that. Hopefully Cry will get another disease. Wouldn't that be cool? So Cry pretty much losing out on that. Bleed resist was a 70%. And then you got the fits, which drops everything. Lucky times. I see what Maggie. You want to try to bolster for everyone's speed and dodge. Really wish Cry could have gone again this turn, but hey, what can you really do? Jesse's bleed did not land. Alright, let's try to go for a stun on one of them just to get a little bit of damage. Or, you know, we could just miss, that's fine too. It's good. It's pretty good. I wish the computer missed every now and then. Alright, so Jesse's bleed is going to be able to kill one of the stingers. Maggie did not pass her stun roll of 130%, which is good. So he will be one off lethal, count it. The bleed will kill the other stinger. We have to go for stress healing now.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Stun here would be great, Kurt. There we go. Get a little bit of luck there with the stun. Gives us time to heal up a little bit. Cry can start throwing down the dunks on the ghoul. This is a back, by the way, this is a respawn from us having to turn around and go back this way up the elbow. Thought about going for a hand of light there, but I don't think it's really going to matter. We'll have Kurt continue to bolster the dodge here. Actually, go for Jesse. And even more surprised than they hit it on Jesse. Jesse's going to stress heal himself here. And again, another stun would be great, Kurt. Yeah, there we go. Kurt being Mr. Johnny on the spot with the stuns. Trying to catch Jesse back up. He's not down by that much. And the stacking damage of Cry is really starting to get out of control on the ghoul. He's taking for 18 now. And stun's not going to land. I'm just doing this for damage, really. We should probably put Crush back. Wow, that actually landed. Okay. I'm not going to argue with that. I know the game's probably not going to be happy about that, but that landed through 135% resist. It's pretty good, Kurt. I'm impressed. And let's see. 16, 15. I have Jesse kill his own stress here. I was hoping for a crit heal, but there we go.
The bigger the beast, the greater the glory.
A lot of gold. More so than I was actually expecting. Take that. We really don't use anti-venom in the cove. And we have to remember that we also have a secret door. We'll probably end up camping in the secret door, maybe? We got plenty of food. I feel like camping now might be a little bit premature. So I think I'm just going to go into the secret door and grab whatever's in there and then leave. First hunger vent. This is kind of whatever. Alright, so let's get rid of this key. We don't really need the other key anymore now.
If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
Get rid of crests. And again, I don't remember if we actually need portraits or not. It's something I really should be paying attention to, but...
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted.
And a respawn behind us, but I don't really care about that. Alright, so we end up getting the secret door and the full artifact, which is good. End up getting some crests anyway. I figured you have to figure that you're probably going to be able to get the crests anyway, so throwing them away early is not that big of a deal. I mean, yeah, crests are used for everything, but you know, you can also, of course, trade crests for other heirlooms. I don't think anyone actually has any negative quirks that I care about. Calm is kind of bad, but it doesn't matter really. I mean, both of these really don't. We don't care about that. They don't have any. I mean. I don't really want to remove Witness, because Witness, again, is one of those permanent negative quirks that don't actually inherently affect the characters. So, and Calm is, again, annoying, but it's not that big of a deal. Both of these, I really don't care, because we don't use the Jester for range attacks, so... We actually don't need a negative quirk removal. But thanks for trying, though, game. I like where your head's at. Just quit being such a jerk all the time and killing my high-level healers just out of nowhere. I'd appreciate that even more. 110% for everybody. Nice.
Ambushed by,
I should mention that the base level for champion level traps is 135%. So we're only really failing. We're honestly only really failing like a 25% roll there, I believe. Unless my math is off, which is possible. I do want gold. So we have the option to not go. We don't have to go down here. We can just go up to this arm over here if we need to. We can still camp. We'll probably end up camping very soon just so we can open up the inventory space. Obviously with the stress heal or the stress spam they're going to get from the Tide Master and the Madman, this could be a little bit painful. Let's go ahead and speed everyone up. We're also going to bolster here first just to get things rolling. Surprised I actually hit on Maggie. Luckily, she did resist everything. Drop your damage and accuracy by a bit. Kurt's gonna bolster. Alright, everyone should be faster than the enemy team, though. Shut by Cry. Go for a slice off on that. Did not get the bleed, unfortunately. Gonna continue to bolster with Kurt. Got the kill on the Tide Master, which is good. Yeah, I think we can debuff him a little bit more. Alright, so the Madman's down after this turn. That's a lot of stress on Kurt, though. A whole lot of stress. We'll probably have to start guarding Maggie soon. Cry can start chipping away at the HP of the Savage. We'll get a heal off. Nice crit heal by Maggie. Get a little bit more stress healing there. Kirk can guard Maggie.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Nice dodge by Kurt. And yeah, so we don't really have anything to worry about now. Kurt's taking care of Maggie. He's got protection. He's got a whole lot of stress healing. We've got bolster, we've got dodge. Pretty much unkillable in this fight at this point. Nice double heal by Maggie. 30 total. Monster heal. Did not break the guard of Kurt, which is nice. Cry just gonna keep on pouring on the damage. Jesse gonna mow down all that stress. Yeah, so we're debuffing his damage and accuracy by a lot. On top of the fact that our dodge is way up, he shouldn't be able to hit anything, even though he just did. That's so much damage that Cry is able to do. Plague Doctor, one of the most, I feel like, underrated classes in the game. I'm not saying that people think that they're bad or anything, I just think that their value is kind of lost a little bit on some people. Plague Doctors, they are really good. There we go. And with this, that should be the end of Mr. Savage here. Alright. Nice job by Jesse, rounding out everyone's stress. Maggie, of course, keeping everyone topped off beautifully. There we go. Easy peasy, no problem at all. Got a lot of gold back for it, which is good. I'm gonna just get rid of the bandages now. And I guess we could open this chest. Surprised it's not trapped, actually. 50 gold and a trinket. Don't really care about that. Yeah, we can go ahead and camp now.
A spark without kindred.
I'm actually not going to use a whole lot of food here. Without hope. Let's see. We'll use tactics for that. We definitely want to remove the disease on... Oh, we can't do that on Cry. Oh, that's sad face. No one else has a disease, do they? I guess we can go maintain equipment, and then we can go accuracy crit on Kurt. We'll put crush on Kurt.
The way is lit. The path is clear.
Instead of using command, we use crush. Command doesn't really help us here because we're not. This is not a direct damage dealing party. This is a damage over time party. So, all right. Try this again. Nice. Two misses in a row.
This is the trap maker's art. His efficacy unwitnessed by his own eyes.
We're coming back with honestly a lot of gold, way more gold than we probably should have had. But again, I'm not going to complain about it, or I'm not going to kick it out of bed for eating crackers, if you know what I mean.
Singular strike.
Nice hit by Cry. Go for a crush. Nice hit by Kurt. And we'll go for a slice off on him. Nice miss by Jesse. And then we'll drop your accuracy and damage. Alright. Should have been a little bit better than that. It would have been nice if Jesse hadn't have missed, but what can he do? Gonna guard him. We definitely want to take out the Pelagic Tide Master if we can. That should be enough. There we go. Alright, so the Tide Master's down. Don't have to worry about him. Kurt, we can use a stun to break the guard on the champion. Unless if we miss a 70% roll, that's fine. 70% versus 144% base, mind you. 139, excuse me. I apologize, game. Where were my manners robbing you of 5 whole percent? So we'll start burning down, I guess, the champion, since we can't break the guard of the champion on the other champion. A stun would be nice here, Kurt. I'm not gonna lie. I would be most happy with a stun. I would also be most happy if Maggie would stop missing everything. There we go. So we finally broke the guard. They're gonna go after Maggie in retaliation. And we don't have to really worry about a bleed from the champion. It doesn't deal nearly as much damage as the arterial punch pinch does. crush. Kurt actually hit for 13, 300% protection. That's pretty impressive. Heal here. Nice heal by Maggie. Actually killed all the stress in Jesse, which is nice. So, one more round and the champion should be dead. I'm going to assume that Kurt can hit him for 4. I hope that I'm not mistaken on that. Alright, hit him for 5, good enough. Another beautiful heal by Maggie. This one's just about over here. Cultist champion will die. We'll probably go ahead and cure the bleed on Maggie here before the next round. Well, when the next round happens, I mean. Preemptively bolster in case there's another fight very soon. Cry can kill the bleed on Maggie before it ticks again. Jesse kills the stress on Cry, and we're all perfect. There we go. Let's go ahead. We might as well buff up Kurt even more, because I guess hell, why not? There we go. So look at all those stats. Some tasty buffs. Alright. Gonna keep it simple. Kill the stress dealers. Try to control the damage dealers, etc., etc. So he's already dead. He's gonna get one stress. Yeah, he actually missed. He's gonna get one attack off, and that's that. See if we can goad the piranha into engaging Kurt. Maggie, I don't know what to tell you with these misses. It's incredible how many you've had this run, I'm not gonna lie. I'm glad that we upgraded that weapon for you. You're putting that weapon to good use, Maggie. Alright, so Kurt gets the finishing blow on him. Hey, we gotta do something for Maggie here. Jesse doesn't really have much of an option for anything. I think over a stun is actually not a bad idea here. We did land it, which is good. Maggie might be able to hit a stun target now. She did. It's a miracle. Right, so he is dead no matter what next turn. So I guess we use Cry to try to top off Kurt, because there's no reason not to at this point. Jesse, sure. Keep on buffing. There we go. Kurt's finally been topped off again. And let's just go. Let's just bolster for the heck of it. Why not? There we go. More food and gold is great. Lots of fights. Lots and lots of fighting. For the medium mission, this has been an unusually large amount of fighting. Really wish Jesse would hit one of those bleeds. It's actually not the one I wanted to go for. I wanted to go for the one up front, but what can you do? Nice hit by Kurt. So he is going to be one off lethal. That's good. So we weren't able to kill one on the first turn without being surprised. We would have if the bleed had actually passed the 95% roll, but didn't happen. Cry gets the dunk. Go ahead and work on Kurt a little bit. We're going to have Kurt defend Maggie just to give him some protection, because 33% is not enough. We know that the Blight from Cry is going to kill the Pelagic Tidemaster. We'll guard Maggie again. Just the act of Kurt using defend on somebody raises his protection by 45%, so he really shouldn't be getting hit at all. And we're just gonna get another disease. What is Kurt's disease resist, I wonder? Let's find out. 30. Really don't like getting diseases, because that means that we pretty much have to take them out for the next round. Yes, I know that vertigo, I mean, it's like, yeah, why would you even care about that? It's a matter of principle. I don't like having anything negative on my characters. I like bringing the best possible party in the best possible shape to a fight. And having to deal with random diseases means that I'm going to be at a little bit of a disadvantage, meaning that you really don't want to be at a disadvantage in anything in Darkest Dungeon if you can help it. You see, everyone out there has seen how out of control this game can get. So you really want to try to shore up your defenses in every possible way. So Jesse's going to finish killing the rest of the crits off. Stress damage off from the crits, I should say. I'm gonna refresh our guard on Maggie. Nice heal by Maggie. There we go. All stress taken care of. And this piranha should be dead after this turn, I hope. So he's definitely done. I'm gonna bolster here just in case there's another fight coming up that we can't see yet. Again, this does run through the duration of us walking. It's not just for this combat. Same thing goes for Jesse's buffs. In case there's a fight in the next like two rooms or so that we might not be able to see yet.
But a victory nonetheless.
I get rid of the portraits. Surprising amounts of gold. Considering this isn't a dark run, it's only a medium mission, this is a lot of gold that we're bringing. I'm almost considering dropping the bust too, just to max out our gold. I mean, if we can get gold, it's going to be nice. We definitely need it. You always need gold in this game, don't ever forget that. Just not even going to care about those anymore, to be honest. Alright, so we're going to continue adventuring here. I think it's worth it if we can get a little bit more gold.
Secrets and wonders can be found in the most tenebrous corners of this place.
We don't fear the dark in this game, in this group at least. The double dodge. See, everyone's camping buffs are still up to date right now. Hopefully Jesse lands a bleed. He finally landed a bleed, very nice. He's gonna be one off lethal, count it. Go for a guard on Maggie. And Maggie can throw down and miss again. The amount of misses that Maggie has had in this run are legendarily high. We're not facing, I mean, she's fought these enemies before. I don't know why she's missing them now, but she is just not hitting. She cannot hit the broadside of not only a brown barn door, but just a brown bar in general. I don't even know what that means. Big hit by Kurt.
Executed.
Huge heal by Maggie too, man. At least she can heal. You can say what she would, she might be as blind as a bat, but my god, when it comes down to actually landing a heal, Maggie is on the case. Start burning down this champion here. Getting a stun would be nice. Also, one-shotting would have been even nicer. So, yeah, you see how much of the dynamic that changed with us just giving Kurt another attack instead of having him become this buff battery type role here. One-off lethal, count it. There we go. More gold.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
Throw away the shovel now, just because. I mean, if we find a shovel event, we just simply leave.
Wealth beyond measure, awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
So a pretty substantially large amount of gold here, and I am not going to complain about that at all. Let's see how much we actually got. On top of the 9,000, we collected. Yeah, 23,000. So it's going to be 32,580 gold on top of selling the Dark Tambourine. Now, obviously, we don't care about the deeds, but yeah, that's not a bad run at all. So we got hard skin with 10% protection is great. Wheel Tactician, I mean, it was kind of a side grade there. It doesn't really matter. But now we have to deal with the disease
treatments. There is a great horror beneath the manor. A crawling chaos that must be destroyed.
So let's unequip all the trinkets and we'll sell the Dark Tambourine. I really don't like the Dark Tambourine. I used to use it in the Twitch TV playthrough, but not anymore. So let's get rid of Vertigo for Kurt. Who else had the other one? It was Cry. Get rid of the fits for Cry. And Tanzog needs to get that disease off, but I still want to lock in. Like, Deadly's not the greatest for a jester, but Faded's really good. And we don't care about Unquiet Mind, so there we go. We do that. Filmbeck also needs to get rid of he still has quite a ways to go as far as his negative quirks. Dyrone or Praxis. What does Praxis have? Off guard, Stress Eater. Yeah, Stress Eater's got to get taken care of. There we go. All right, everyone, I'm going to wrap up there. Very good run overall, and it feels good to get back on the wagon and just start trying to pick up the pieces and get right back where we left off. Again, I do appreciate it. Thank you all for the support. Thank you all for the new subs. And, of course, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!